Guten Tag and willkommen zu einer weiteren versallenden Show. Sie sehen sich die CSS Exclusive Show. Mein Name ist Julia Zenzie Burnham. If you are wondering what language I was speaking, it is the German language, and basically I was saying, welcome to another riveting show of the CSS Exclusive. I am your hostess, Julia Zenzie Burnham, and I am here with my co-host, Sipho Seroto, who is on the other side of town. How are you doing there, Sipho?
Danke, Julia. Mir geht es gut. Ich bin froh, so gut. Das wirst du gut Deutsch sprechen können. Thank you, Julia. I was basically saying that what a way to start our show today. And you are looking so lovely there. This is CSS Exclusive. Thank you so much for joining us. I am Sipho Seroto. We are coming to you from Germany. And this is a show where we tend to learn and discover about different places and different lifestyles that people live. Remember that you can also be part of this show by putting your comments on our social media platforms. This is CSS Exclusive. Over to you now, Julia.
Thank you, Sipho. The interesting fact about watching CSS Exclusive Show is that you get to discover and tour with us within the comfort of your own home, your working place, or anywhere you are able to watch this show. We are in a city called Duisburg in western Germany at the junction of the Rhine and the Ruhr rivers. We are indeed going to have a great time on the CSS Exclusive Show. You are welcome to post your comments about this show on our Facebook page, which is CSS_SA, as well as on our YouTube channel. You will also find us on CSS_SA.
Thank you for joining us on this edition of the CSS Exclusive Show. We are in a town called Duisburg in Dusseldorf region in Germany, and we will also explore about Germany in general. Duisburg is a city located in western Germany. As Julia mentioned, it lies at the junction of the Rhine and Ruhr rivers and is connected with the North Sea German ports by the Rhine-Herne Canal, which links it to Dortmund and therefore with the Dortmund EMS Canal. Known to the Romans as Castrum Ditonis, it was mentioned in 740 as Dispergum, a seat of the Frankish kings. Chartered in 1129, it became a free imperial city until it passed to Cleves in 1290, and with Cleves to Brandenburg in 1614. After suffering heavily in the Dutch Wars of Independence and the Thirty Years' War,
It revived as the seat of a Protestant university from 1655 to 1818. Duisburg's modern importance dates from increasing industrialization after 1880 and its absorption on the outer communities of Ruhrort, which includes the harbor and Miederich in 1905, and Hamborn, the chief industrial area, Hochfeld, Neudorf, and Dessen in 1929. Duisburg was occupied by Belgian troops between 1921 to 1925 and was called Duisburg-Hamborn from 1929 to 1934. The union of Duisburg and the outlying centers made it one of the world's largest inland ports and one of the Western Europe's principal iron and steel centers. In 1975, the outlying cities of Rheinhausen, Homberg, Niederrhein, Rumen-Gardenhausen, and Walsum were annexed, enlarging the city yet again. Duisburg's modern economy is still based on the port, which is among the busiest inland ports in the world. The city also remains a coal mining and iron and steel manufacturing center. Other manufactured products include chemicals, paint, ships, beer, and foodstuffs. Although the center of the city, the Bergplatz, is on the site of the Frankish court and a later foundation in 1253 of the Knights of the Teutonic Order, there are a few traces of Duisburg's pre-industrial past. The 14th century Gothic Salvator Church and the 12th century Romanesque Premonstratensian AB Church survived the destruction of the Second World War.
Interesting thing about watching the CSS exclusive show is that you can watch it from the comfort of your own home, your working environment, or anywhere you are able to catch this show. Do it. We are in a beautiful city called Duisburg in western Germany, and we are at the junction of the Rhine and Ruhr rivers.
There are museums for municipal arts. The Lembrack Museum honors famed local sculptor Willem Lembrack and local history, and a zoo with a large aquarium. In 2003, the University of Duisburg Essen was created by the union of existing universities in the two cities. At 1,148 feet, which is 350 meters, the Duisburg-Nieuwkamp Bridge across the Rhine is one of the world's longest span truss structures. Duisburg, a city which became famous for its extensive coal mining and industrial metal and steel production. It is considered not necessarily a beautiful city, but one that might be worth visiting to explore its cultural and historical benefits. With a population of approximately 500,000 people, it is situated in the North Rhine-Westphalia, close to Dusseldorf, which is the capital of that state. Duisburg is fairly admired for its emerald parks, lakes, and outdoor leisure facilities, its culture with many museums and art galleries, and the famous Koning Brewery is well known throughout Germany. Duisburg have a number of points of interest, which include Landschaftspark in Duisburg Nord, Tiger and Turtle, Duisburg Zoo, Duisburg Inner Harbor, Seeschenplatte, Ruhr, Halde Haniel, and Lembrack Museum. Germany is home to 80.3 million people. Its capital city of Berlin has a population of 3.3 million people. Germany has the largest population of all the countries in the European Union and is considered a major political and economical power in Europe. Its currency is the euro, which is used widely across Europe. The official language of Germany is German, and the country does not have an official religion, although Christianity is practiced widely throughout the country. The flag of Germany is comprised of three horizontal stripes, one black, one red, and one yellow. Germany is bordered by Denmark to the north, Czech Republic to the east, Austria and Switzerland in the south, France and Luxembourg to the southwest. The total nominal GDP is $3.4 trillion, which makes it the fourth largest economy in the world, while its nominal per capita GDP is $41,513, which is the 22nd highest in the world. Germany is the fifth largest purchasing power country, the second largest exporter of goods in the world, and the third largest importer of goods in the world. Germany's standard of living is very high, and each German citizen is entitled to a universal healthcare system and a comprehensive social security plan. The government in Germany is a federal parliamentary constitutional republic. All of Germany is broken into 16 states. Each state is largely autonomous and has its own constitution. Manufacturing is a key part of Germany's economy. They are one of the top manufacturers in the world of cars, boats, and certain electronics. Germany is home to numerous natural resources. Their land is rich in copper, nickel, uranium, coal, and other natural gas. Approximately 100 German citizens have received a Nobel Prize. Germany is known worldwide for having great beer. At the time of the Roman Empire, Germany was populated by countless barbarian tribes that valued their freedom fiercely. Unlike Spain, France, and England, the Roman Empire was never able to conquer Germany or Germania, as the Romans called it. The union of Duisburg and the outlying centers made it one of the world's largest inland ports and one of the Western Europe's principal iron and steel centers. In 1975, the outlying cities of Rheinhausen, Homberg, Niederrhein, Rumen, Gelsenhausen, and Walsum were annexed, enlarging the city yet again.
As we are here in the Landschaftspark, the Head and the Load show is taking place. But to get more information about the Head and the Load show, you can kindly visit the website, which is www.theheadandtheload.com, and you'll get more information about the show. And then, Julia, the interesting fact also about this place is that there's rich information behind it. But then, in order for us now to explore more about the Landschaftspark, which is based here in Germany, in Düsseldorf, let's have a look at the following insert about the Landschaftspark, which shows the visuals, the detailed visuals about this place.
most disused industrial sites are either seen as a dangerous eyesore and torn down, or fenced off and hidden away, calling it to intrepid urban explorers. The former steelworks, now known as the Landschaftspark in Duisburg North in Duisburg, Germany, was turned into a public park that celebrates the site's brutal beauty and productive heritage. Most disused industrial sites are either seen as a dangerous eyesore and torn down, or fenced off and hidden away, calling it to intrepid urban explorers. The former steelworks, now known as the Landschaftspark in Duisburg North in Duisburg, Germany, was turned into a public park that celebrates the site's brutal beauty and productive heritage. The coal works on the site were first established in 1901 to take advantage of the fields of ore on the site. A blast furnace was built, and from there a slow series of other coal and eventually iron and steel facilities were added down the decades until the site was a fully functioning plant complex. As demand for steel dipped in the later 20th century, the factory was eventually abandoned in the mid-80s, leaving behind an ominous industrial hulk and immense amounts of pollution. However, instead of blasting the land clean of the forsaken metal works, it was decided that the facilities would be refurbished and turned into a public park where the memory of the plant's good work could live and be appreciated by the future generations once the pollution was cleaned up. After extensive purging of the toxins that had poisoned the site and general refurbishment of the works, the Landschaftspark Duisburg North was born. Many of the facilities were repurposed into such grand spaces such as a massive concert hall and even Europe's largest indoor drive site. However, what is likely most stunning to the casual visitor is the neon light show that appears after dark painting the otherwise hard-edged grim site into a sort of sci-fi dystopia. It takes about 30 to 40 minutes to get to the Landschaftspark from the central station. More than 30 years ago, the site was still being worked on. Today, there is a unique area for events of all kinds. on 180 hectares. You can enjoy the disused workshops as well as on open-air areas. Any event will be able to host 15,000 visitors. Germany, a Western European country with a landscape of forests, rivers, mountain ranges and North Sea beaches. The seventh largest country in Europe, covering an area of 137,847 square miles, of which 34,836 square miles is covered by land and 3,011 square miles contains water. The Thyssen Ironworks in Duisburg, Niederrhein, built in the grandiose style, so typical of the time of advanced industrialization, finally saw production come to an end with the last tapping of Blast Furnace 5 on 4th April 1985. At the same time, this was also the beginning of an unbelievable period of development. Through the contrast between continuous redevelopment and the contestant need for preservation, an industrial wasteland has developed into a unique adventure playground for young and old, a development which is ongoing. The idea for a new type of natural man-made landscape with industrial stamp was born in 1989. Based on designs by Professor Peter Lance and partner, a landscape park has been created on the North Duisburg site, measuring roughly 180 hectares, which is neither park nor landscape in the traditional sense.
Wow, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That is the Landschaftspark. We've seen a detailed information about this area. We've seen some visuals of this area and the information behind it. How did it start? And that's a very interesting information. The important thing is that is to preserve the history that the area have. Like, for example, here in the Landschaftspark, there are a lot of tourists who are coming here to take pictures and coming to explore about this area. And this is CSS Exclusive. Remember that you can also post your comments about this show on our YouTube channel and as well as on our Facebook page. Our Facebook page is CSS_SA, and on YouTube you can also find us on CSS_SA. Thank you so much for joining us. Julia, let me cross over to you now. What is it that is interesting that you have on your side? Let's hear more from Julia.
Thank you, Sipho. Now we are currently at the Landschaftspark, and with me I've got a beautiful guest who is part of the Head and the Load project. Could you introduce yourself for the viewers at home?
My name is Laurie Cearley, and I'm one of the producers for William Kentridge on the Head and the Load.
Cool. So this is Laurie. Let's welcome Laurie, everybody, from home, your workplace, or anywhere that you are. Now, Laurie, do you mind telling us more about the Head and the Load? What does the Head and the Load talk about?
I mean, I think the Head and the Load, you know, it is a story of Africa, of the First World War, but also the people that you never hear about. When you hear, especially in Europe, you hear about, you know, the war, you hear about the Germans, the English, the French, but you never hear about what goes on out there. Mm-hmm. And this is a story, you know, about what happens out there, but I see it more of, as opposed to a linear story, it's kind of a diorama of things that can happen, and there's the, you know, and all sorts of things come in and out, and there's an arc of the story, and it's a beautiful kind of snapshot. You are invited in to look at many things and to make an opinion, and then you walk away. So it's not a linear story, so I find it very fascinating.
I happen to be part of the cast of The Head and the Load, but Laurie, can you tell our viewers at home, how long will this Head and the Load run? Within this year, possibly next year?
So hopefully. We're here in Germany. We opened at the Tate Modern in London. We are going to New York. Very exciting. In December. After that, we're going to the Holland Festival in May 2019. We are going to Athens, possibly. And moving forward, we have had interest from Montreal, Paris. Montreal, Paris, Yale, North Carolina. But our dream, the big dream, is to take it back to South Africa.
And that is the dream, to take it back to Africa, as this talks about the Africans who were involved in the First World War. Stories untold, stories unseen, stories unheard of. Hidden the load. Thank you very much. Thank you, Laurie.
My pleasure.
Well, thank you so much, Julia. You are watching CSS Exclusive. That's a very conversation. That's a very good conversation that you had with Mrs. Laurie Cearley. Thank you so much. And here behind me, I'm standing behind a very heavy-duty steel here. It's a steel train. I think it seems like one of those trains that they used coal in order to operate. But you can tell this is an old train because of it. It is made up of heavy-duty steel. There's no fiberglass components or contents onto this train. And I can tell that this train has been existing for hundreds and hundreds of years. As you can see right now, the train now is like something that the tourists can come here and have a look at. And it's a very old-fashioned train. This is a very old machine, but then it's no longer operating now. It's been standing here now, and I think tourists can come here and explore about this train. And the nice thing about going to different places is that we got to explore and learn about different things that are so unique about a certain area. As we are coming to you here from Europe, we are in the German Empire, and thank you so much for joining us. For now, let's kindly have a look at what is it more that we can explore about Germany. This is CSS Exclusive. Remember to find us also on our social media platforms as well as on our YouTube channel. You can find us on CSS_SA. On YouTube, on Facebook, you can find us on CSS_SA as well. Thank you so much. This is CSS Exclusive. We are coming to you from Dusseldorf in Duisburg. That is in Germany, Europe. Thank you so much. Let's come in. Let's go and see that. What is it more that we can be able to explore as well?
Germany is one of the world's largest car producers. Selling 5.9 million cars in 2011, VW's Golf is one of the best-selling cars of all time. In 2012, it sold more than 430,000 Golfs around Europe. In 2013, the top-selling car brands in Germany were Volkswagen, Mercedes, Audi, BMW, a country with more than 1,500 different beers. One of the greatest experiences we had in Germany is the good hospitality we got from Mrs. Marcell Mogaki Niederhood, a wife of Mr. Niederhood who lives in Duisburg. The experience at Mr. and Mrs. Niederhood's home was so great, whereby Mrs. Marcell Mogaki Niederhood offered us delicious African food. Mrs. Marcell also told us about how the Germans support arts. She explained to us that most German residents go out in numbers to support stage plays and contemporary arts.
Welcome back. You are watching CSS Exclusive. We are coming to you from Duisburg in Germany. We are in the European Union. Thank you so much for joining us. Earlier on, we had a very great experience about different and interesting stories about Germany. You are watching CSS Exclusive. Our show is exclusive to you on our YouTube channel. You'll find us on CSS_SA as well as on our Facebook page, which is CSS_SA. Remember also to post your comments about this show on our social media platforms. Right now, the time now is almost 27 before 11 o'clock at night, and the interesting fact about this area is that we are on the same time zone as South Africa. Like right now it's 22:33, and you find that also in South Africa it's 22:33 at night.
For being a beautiful part of this journey with us. I mean, it has been a beautiful experience. The country of Germany is really beautiful. Remember to catch us on CSS_SA on our Facebook page, and you can also catch us on YouTube, CSS_SA. Thank you very much, and I welcome Sipho.
Yes, thank you so much, Julia. It's been quite a good journey that we had, right?
Yep.
Yes, but then we'd kindly like to thank you also, our viewers at home, for being part of this show. We hope that you have learned a lot about Germany, the history about Germany, the culture that we explored about the people in Germany, mm-hmm. and it's been an amazing place that you have been to. Remember that you can also catch this program on our YouTube channel. Catch us on CSS_SA. Remember also to post your comments on our Facebook page, which is also CSS_SA. Remember to visit www.theheadandtheload.com to get more information about The Head and the Load. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure to be with you. Up until we meet again on CSS Exclusive, it's been a pleasure to be with you. Thank you for watching.
Goodbye.
Scatterings and fugitives who African idea, African.